test assignment, a very simple test. Do you use Rudy's woman?
Indeed.
What a better society we would have constituted if only a man could see a woman. Every year, on the 8th of March, we celebrate International Women's Day. Women are wished a happy Women's Day. But is this world, as it is now, a really very happy place for women to live in? Let me rephrase my question. When was the last time you opened a newspaper and didn't find a single report on crimes against women? Rapes of old women and young girls, babies, molestation, domestic violence, harassment at the workplace, female feticide. These have become like our everyday affairs. They don't even draw attention anymore. Major rapes go unnoticed. Now, the question that arises is, who's to blame for this plight of women? At this point, I would like to remind you of an incident that happened in Delhi 3 years ago. Following the brutal assault and attempted murder of a 23-year-old Palestine student, later called as Nirbhaya, on the 16th of December 2012, huge crowds of angry civilians infiltrated the streets of Delhi in protest. The entire country criticized the government and the police force for this incident. However, what we failed to realize was, while we were pointing at the government, the remaining three fingers were pointing at us, the society. Unfortunately, we live in a society where women are dauntlessly objectified, consciously or subconsciously. Women degrading movies run in our theaters successfully. Most of our advertisements portray women as objects of desire, and what's worse, television sets being available in every household, children are exposed to these obscene commercials right from the very inception of their emotional maturity. It's very difficult for us to fathom what effect this has on their young minds. We live in a society where a woman's character is judged on the basis of the clothes she wears, where genes are proclaimed to be the causes of rape. According to a popular Hindi terminology, the assault of a woman is said to be the loss of her dignity and self-respect. However, it is high time that we realize that it is not the woman, but her harasser who loses her self-respect. But how often do we think like that? I thereby urge you, my friends, to be the change that you want to witness. To protest against whatever you consider wrong. To protest when it happens right in front of your eyes. Lighting candles with protest thereafter won't do any good. Respect a woman for the sole fact that she's a woman. See a woman.